So, Bismillah Rahman, we have to now today the topic is pharmaceutical powder. So, we have to three lectures on this. And the first one is this, we are discussing about this. So, first we go, you can see in this, the shape of the picture in the powder, you can see different colors of powder over there. So, what you can say define? So, you can define as powders are mixtures of dry, finally, divided drugs and or chemicals that may be intended for internal or external use. How to define powder or mixture? They may be dry or finely divided drugs. They may be dry drugs or chemicals. They may be divided drugs or chemicals that may be intended for internal or external, for both purposes, internal use and for external application, for local application or for oral use. So these are the known as divided definition of the finally divided drugs or chemicals are known as powders. First, the term powder may be used to describe how to describe the physical form of a material that is a dry substance composed of finely divided particles, or it may be used to describe a type of pharmaceutical preparation that is medicated powder intended for internal oral powder, external topical powders. So it can be any dry substance composed of finely divided part is a powder. Further, pharmaceutical preparation is have a for oral powder or for topical powder. In continuation of the previous definition, powder may be used to describe may for topical use or for oral powders. You can see the different type of picture over here. On the left side, there is a topical powder. You may have know about the Sicatrin powder. This may be placed over the, sprayed over the wounds, cuts whenever some time has. Another one is oral powder. These are in the form of nutrition. In the form of nutrition, that's also in the form of a powder. In the middle one, there is a baby powder. That's the baby powder which has to be spread over the body when there is a needed. So these all are, there's still so many forms of powders are available. These are the forms of powders, topical or oral powder. In both sides, I have told you that oral powder which has to be intended to be used through the mouth or oral cavity, and topical powder which has to be spread over the skin or cut wherever there. Then in the middle one is a baby powder, which can be used for smoothness of the skin. Although use of medicated powder is therapeutic is limited, the use of powders substance in the preparation of is extensive. So the basic, yes, it is very limited nowadays due to the availability of different other dosage forms or other drugs. So the powders were mostly, you can see the Sicatrin powder is only used for that one, for cuts and abrasion over the skin over there. Further, we can have examples. Powder drugs may be blended with powders fillers. They have for fillers and other pharmaceutical ingredients to fabricate solid dosage forms as tablets and capsules. They can be helpful in the formulation of other dosage forms. They can be used in the formulation of tablets, as we have learned in tablets that they are used as a filler and other forms to fabricate solid form as tablet and capsules, whatever it is. Second use, they may be dissolved or suspended in solvents or liquids or liquid vehicles to make various liquid dosage forms. So still they can be used in liquid dosage forms. They may be incorporated into semi-solid bases in the preparation of medicated ointments and creams. So one first, the use was that in topical or in oral use is just as a dosage forms, as a therapeutic agent. But they are also used in different formulation of various dosage forms in the tablets, capsules, in liquid dosage forms, and in ointment and creams, they can be used. Now, what are the advantages of powders and what are disadvantages of powders? Advantage is that they are more stable than liquids, more convenient to swallow than tablet or capsules. used in blending with medicated applications as ointments, suppositories, and pastes. Can be prepared into granules for use in preparing tablet and are reconstituted to liquid forms. Rapid therapeutic effect due to a large surface area. Useful for bulky drugs with large dose. Disadvantage is that they are unpleasant tasting of drugs. It is difficult to protect powders containing hygroscopic deliquescent tending to melt or dissolve in human environment or aromatic materials from decomposition. Third is time and expenses required in the preparation of uniform powders are great. Patient may misunderstand the correct method of use. Without clear instructions, patient may inhale through the nose a drug intended for oral administrations. Before their use, in the preparation of pharmaceutical products, solid material first are characterized to determine their chemical and physical features, including its morphology, its purity, its solubility, flowability, stability, particle size, uniformity, compatibility. Now, particle size and analysis. The particles of pharmaceutical powders and granules may range from being extremely coarse, about 10 millimeters in diameter, to extremely fine, approaching colloidal dimension of 1 micrometer or less. So its particles range from 1 centimeter to 1 micrometers. In order to characterize the particle size of given powders, the United States USP used these descriptive terms about the powders. Number one is very coarse. Very coarse means composed of relatively large parts or particles, means larger sizes. Coarse, rough or harsh in textures. Moderately coarse, a powder, all the particles which pass through a sieve with the nominal mesh apparatus. Fine, then very fine. So these are five categories of definition of particles. These terms are related to the proportion of powders that is capable of passing through the opening of standard sieves of varying fineness in a specified period while being shaken generally in a mechanical sieve. So they can pass through a sieve. You can see the different size of sieves from which the powder can pass. Different size, larger sieves and the smaller sieves. So they have different size of sieves. The figure expresses the standard sieve numbers and the opening in each expressed in millimeters. So sieve number 2, it has opening of 9.5 millimeter. Sieve number 3.5, it has 5.60 millimeter. Sieve number 4, 8, 10, the different numbers have different sieve openings. The last one is 400 number means 38 micrometer size can pass through that, very small. Similarly, you can read these numbers and sieve numbers and how much size of powder can pass through that sieves. Powder of vegetable and animal foreign drugs are officially defined as follow. Very coarse, they can pass through the number 8. All particles pass through number 8 sieve and not more than 20% pass through the number 60. So very, number 8 means, coarse means number 8, they can pass through the number 8 sieve and they through not number 60. Coarse means number 20, all particles pass through number 20 sieve and not more than 40% pass through a number 60 sieve. Moderately coarse, number 40, all particles pass through a number 40 sieve. Fine, number 60, all particles pass through a number 60 sieve and not more than 40% pass through a number 100 sieve. Very fine means 80, all particles pass through a number 80 sieve, there is no limit to greater finance. So these are various numbers and these are various size of the particle which can pass through the various sieves. Granules typically fall within the range of 4 to 12 sieve size. Now granules which are going to be prepared for the tablets and other capsules, they can pass through the 4 to 12 sieve size, although granulation of powders prepared in the 12 to 20 sieve range are sometimes used in the tablet making. So you must know about the what size of particle is used in tablet making. The purpose of particle size analysis is pharmacy is to obtain quantitative data on the size, distribution, shape of the drug and other components to be used in pharmaceutical formulations. There may be substantial differences in particle size, crystal morphology, and amorphous characters within and between substances. Particle size can influence a variety of important factors, including the following. First, they have important factor in dissolution rate. Now, dissolution rate of particle intended to dissolve drug micronization can increase the rate of drug dissolution and its bioavailability. Suspendability of particle intended to remain undissolved but uniformly dispersed in a liquid vehicle, example, fine dispersion have particle approximately 0.5 to 10 micrometers. Uniform distribution of a drug substance in the powder, mixture or solid dose form to ensure dose-to-dose content uniformity. Penetrability of particle intended to be inhaled for deposition deep in the respiratory tract need 1 to 5 micromole. Lack of grittiness of solid particle in dermal ointments, creams, and ophthalmic preparations, example, fine powders may be 50 to 100 microgram in size. So you can know these size in which dose forms they are used. For tablets, what size type, what the, for suspensions or for ointments, whatever you have to follow the size according to their factors. Parameter important in particle size determines average particle size and particle size distributions. A number of methods exist for determination of particle size. Sieving. First, we have to, through the sieving. Sieve in which particles are passed by mechanical shaking through a series of sieves of known and successively smaller size, and the proportion of powder passing through or being withheld on each sieve is determined. The range about 40 to 950 micrometers depending upon sieve size. So whatever the sieve they can pass, that is up to their number over there. And then sieving. Sampling, how to take a sample. In order to obtain a powder sample which represents the whole batch, it proceeds as in the following manner. Use a powder sampler by the help of sieve. You can check with the help of sieve open, and then you put this to check the sample for analytical sieving. The importance of obtaining an optimum quantity of powder for sieve analysis is that. Why? Because an excessive quantity of powder, one, could deform the mesh of the sieve, does not permit a regular flowing of the powder over the mesh of the sieve, so a wrong classification will be obtained. So that's why they have to use that apparatus. The sieving process should be carried out automatically to be reproducible. With automatic sieving, 6 to 8 sieve placed one over the other from the higher to the lower sieve. Put a powder sample of 100 gram in the upper sieve, close with its cover, shake for 5 minutes. Nor will the process can be stopped within 1 minute, no more than 1.1% of the powder passes At the end of the process, the powder sample will be distributed between sieves according to their diameters. Sedimentation rate, in which particle is determined by measuring the terminal settling velocity of particles through a liquid medium in gravitational or centrifugal environment. A range 0.8 to 300 micrometers. Sedimentation rate may be calculated from Stokes' law. This process is under the control of Stokes' law. You can see a formula of Stokes' law. When R is the radius of the sphere that has a volume equal to the particle, P is the particle density, PO is the density of the dispersion medium or vehicle, is the velocity of viscosity, nanum, g is the gravity accelerations. Counter. The equipment counts the particles and classifies them in different dimensional classes. It permits to measure the volume of the particles using the conductometric method. Now, microscopy. Particles are sized through the use of calibrated grid, background, or other measuring devices. Range 0.2 to 100 micro. So these can be checked according to these devices. Powder flow technology, flow of powders. Factor that decreases the flow of powders, what? Superficial adhesiveness. Shape of the particles, spherical particles flow quickly, while irregular shaped particles flow slowly. Surface of the particle, a wrinkled surface has low flowability, while smooth surface have high flowability. The presence of electrostatic charge on the surface of the particles, the hygroscopicity of the powders. Disadvantage of bad powder flow, an incomplete and regular filling of dyes or a bottle is achieved. Advantage of good powder flow, filling the dyes in very short time. This means complete and regular filling of dyes or bottles.